What makes the matter of a tree made up? I was thinking of the question. Anything that has the cellular structures makes carbon or turns into carbon. Yeah, that's the type of shit that I can't conceptualize.
I wish I was a scientist.
That's beyond me. Yeah. When you start talking at the cellular level, it's the same deal. I understand the basic function of what you're saying to me, but it's way beyond.
I never took chemistry, bro. I don't understand none of this.
No. I operate on this plane. The one that we live on, that's where my brain can work.
Yeah, there you go.
That's it. I consider the philosophies of human beings.
There you go.
That's it. I don't even go to the religious or the theocratic. None of that. I don't even involve myself in that. I'm like, I don't know. I'll figure that out when I'm done. I'm not even going to worry about that now because no one person is right.
Right.
So, yeah. No, I don't even concern myself with those things.
Yeah, that's all right, buddy. Me. The world needs philosophers and scientists.
So the second tier of this chain that I'm drawing out here, right, is an article that I have from the Kitsap Sun, and it is entitled "Murders Up, Police Staffing Down," says Washington Crime Report, right? The number of murders, robberies, serious assaults, and other violent crimes rose significantly in Washington last year, while the number of officers available to respond to them continued to plummet. The head of the organization that collects the data said Wednesday, the Washington Association of Sheriffs and Police Chiefs, released its annual report on crime, finding that violent crime overall increased 12.3% in the state. Although the murder rate per 100,000 residents was slightly higher in the 1980s and early 90s, the number of murders, 325, was the most since the association started tracking the data in 1980. It was up from 302 in 2020 and 201 before the pandemic in 2019. The national murder rate also soared in 2020. So I would imagine that the murder rate 4 per 100,000, because they were also talking about per capita. Meanwhile, there were 495 fewer police officers employed in the state, which already had the nation's fewest officers per capita, said Stephen Strachan, the association's executive director, that left Washington with 10,736 full-time officers, a drop of 4.4% to serve a population that rose 116,000 to more than 7.7 million. We gained over 100,000 people last year.
Hot as dog.
A state.
That's a lot of people. I mean, I could see that. You know, we're kind of like California light up here.
Yeah.
You know, there's a lot of people that might have been a little too, you know, saw the governments get a little overzealous. We're like, you know, Washington, you know, Northwest is still pretty progressive, but they're not totally psychotic like, you know, we are here in LA. Let's go up there. It's pretty. You know, over the last few years, I've seen a lot of people from California move up here.
So, okay. This is stupid. The murder rate, 4 per 100,000 residents, was slightly higher in the 80s and 90s. The number of murders, 325, was the most since the association started the tracking data in the 1980s. So that's because there's more people here than there was in the 1980s and 90s. That murder rate is irrelevant, is what it sounds like.
Yeah, because unless if you do that per capita, you know, then it's kind of like saying that it's the 2% increase.
Yeah, that doesn't mean anything.
Statistic.
Because you just said there were more murders, but the murder rate is down.
Yeah.
That doesn't make any sense.
Yeah, that just means that if on the whole per capita, it seems like the rate went down, but the sheer overall numbers went up, probably due to increased population growth.
Yes. So we saw over the state, and particularly in Seattle, we saw an enormous decline in police officers for multiple different reasons, right?
Huge.
There were... let's see here. Sorry, I'm trying to find.
Governor just had a massive increase in funding for additional police officers in particular Seattle too.
So I found it. So George Floyd, right? That was one thing. When the George Floyd riot started, there was an enormous amount of police officers that quit, also retired. And this is, I want to stop here for a second, because it's like this weird loophole almost that I've heard be used in multiple different outlets. And I'm talking about, well, there's been an enormous amount of retirements, you know, in police officers. Okay, yeah, there was a shitload of people who chose to retire when they could have continued working or would have continued working. There was a shitload of people who retired early instead of just quitting, right?
Yeah.
So they retired early. That this matters, this context matters. And it's like, so I think it's a loophole in this discussion to say, well, there's been so many retirements because there was a bunch of people who retired before they had originally planned to because of these numerous different things, because of George Floyd, the COVID regulations. There was also the vaccine mandate throughout the state. There was, I don't know, hundreds of officers that quit throughout the state because of the vaccine mandates.
Yeah. So the generalized push to be anti-cop for that particular reason, because just, you know, it's the ACAB stuff. You know, I have a very, you know, my take on law enforcement is very, you know, it's very anti-law enforcement, but for a completely different reason. What we saw during our great summer of love, as the Seattle mayor put it, was it was this blatant anti-hate for any kind of authoritarian, you know, law enforcement, due to misguided, misinformed reasons, you know, because cops are racist and they're all just killing black people, or, you know, they're whatever it is, they're bigoted and they're hateful and all this. That's what that push was about.
Right.
You know, like, I have a principled stance against it, but it has nothing to do with that. But that was not the overall push. And it was nationwide. And in some states, we've seen a, for lack of a better term, a refunding of police after the massive defund the cops movement went around. But we, in particular here in Seattle, they were one of the first cities to go really hardcore progressive with their policing system. And they have been well before George Floyd and all that stuff happened. And it's, it has, they've never, ever been able to recover from that.
Well, and it's hilarious because I've told you I found that new local podcast. I don't remember what it's called, but I was listening to, it's called like Morning Brew or fucking something like that. That I don't think you ever followed it or listened to it, but it's one that I've listened to just a few times.
And yeah, so, Seattle Now.
Seattle Now, yes.
By KUOW.
And they just did an episode earlier this week that said Seattle's plan to hire 500 police officers. And in this, they said, well, the Seattle never, you know, defunded the police. So in a matter of 5 seconds, I found an article after a summer, and this is from NBC News, after a summer of protests, Seattle cuts police department budget by nearly 17%. And if you go into the article, you know, the Seattle City Council on Monday cuts its police department budget by nearly 17% in a shift that grew out of this past summer's national protest against systemic racism. The panel's 2021 spending plan called for $340 million to be allocated to Seattle's police department, down from $409 million this year, representatives of the council and mayor said Tuesday. So while they did not cut the department, right, they did not hack off a bunch of officers, they cut the budget, which forced them to make cuts. Because we talked about this, that's part of the reason that Carmen Best quit was because they were going to make her fire a bunch of minority police officers she had just fucking hired. And she said, no, I'm not doing that. So now the new mayor, Bruce Harrell, and the sitting police chief, the interim police chief, that's what I'm looking for, Adrian Diaz, are working on a new plan. They're asking for, what I said, $2 million, I think I told you yesterday, for 500 additional officers and to shore up declining policing staff, police staffing that he says is at crisis levels. And this is from Axios now. The latest, Harold, joined by interim police chief Adrian Diaz, said at a news conference that he's asking the city council for $1 million to help pay for his plan, which includes hiring bonuses of up to $7,500 for new recruits and $30,000 for officers transferring from other departments, paying $1,000 to city employees who refer officer candidates that are hired, and bringing on a recruitment director and other specialists. The plan also widens the officer applicant tool to prioritize hiring more black candidates and other police of color, because they just fucking fired a bunch of them, bilingual recruits, and those with other diverse qualities. Yes, but Harrell asked for another $1 million for police recruitment on top of $1 million already approved in May. Does not cover a key part of his strategy, a package of pay, vacation, and training incentives aimed at retaining already employed officers. They want to add to the retirements, the pensions, and stuff like that. The cost of such retention bonuses remains unknown and is still being negotiated as part of a new collective bargaining agreement with the Seattle Police Officers Guild. Those negotiations likely won't finalize before the city's next budget process in the fall. So the SPD has 950 deployable officers, and that's the lowest they've seen since 91.
950
for the entirety of Seattle.
I remember...
Over 400 officers have exited the department since 2019, including dozens who left in the wake of 2020's tumultuous racial justice protests and calls to defund the police. At the same time, hiring has not kept pace. So far this year, 109 officers have left and 35 have been hired. It is fucking July, and they've hired 35 people.
Dude.
Why the fuck would you want to be a cop in Seattle?
Yeah.
The Seattle Police Department, even prior to this, had a horrific, horrific record of... abuse on citizens.
Yeah.
Horrific record.
Yeah.
Especially minorities. Horrific.
Yep. That's why they were one of the first to kind of go really, really progressive in policing policies.
Yes.
Because it was a serious problem for a long time. And you got to remember, too, Yeah, 950 for Seattle, bro. Yeah. That's not that many.
And that was their argument in the Seattle Now was, well, they didn't cut the budget. They reallocated that money to different types of policing.
Oh, yeah. Community outreach programs.
So you cut it from the police department budget, and you gave that money to other people and expected them to do community policing, which is fine if that's how you want to look at it. Mm-hmm. But don't tell me you didn't fucking cut the police budget when that's exactly what you did, from $409 million to $370 million. When you can look at the numbers, don't try and fucking gaslight me into telling me that you didn't cut the budget.
Yeah.
When we can see the numbers, dog. Welcome to the south of the